In this video, you're going to learn about the best video camera under £1,000. The best video camera is subjective. This is why. To get the best video camera for you, you need to look at some important factors. Number one, what do you plan to record? What are you going to be using the camera to record? Do you need a camera to just record vacations when you go on holiday, vacation in the UK when you go on holiday? Or do you need a camera that you want to use to take photos, to post on Instagram socially, not professionally? Do you need a camera that is an upgrade to your mobile phone? Do you need a camera to record your kids when they're playing in the house, or you go to their sports events, you want to record them? That kind of person just needs a camera for their hobby. It's a hobby for them. Then you have people that need a camera to record YouTube videos, like I'm doing here. You need a camera to take professional photos to post on LinkedIn and to use as your profile photo on LinkedIn. You need a camera to record videos to post on LinkedIn and videos to post on Instagram and other social media platforms for business purposes. So you need a good quality professional camera. And then the third type of people is people that have been professional photographers. I know professional photographers that don't have experience of videography. So if you're that type of person and you're looking for a camera that would help you record high-end professional events like weddings, big weddings and conferences, seminars and stuff like that, then you need a good camera as well. So what I'm trying to say here is the best camera for this three type of people or these categories is totally different. It's subjective. The best camera, in my opinion, is the Canon 90D. And I'm going to give you seven reasons why the Canon 90D is the best video camera. Number one, battery life. You need a camera that has solid battery life. This camera can shoot up to 1,300 photos, one battery. The previous camera that I had, which was a Canon 250D, could only shoot 900 photos. So what I'm trying to say is, the bigger, the better. A camera with a big battery would last longer. A camera with a small battery would do a decent job, but not as good enough as a big camera. The same go with DSLR and mirrorless cameras. The DSLR cameras are big, the battery lasts longer. DSLR, Sony has some very good cameras with good battery life, but DSLRs, mirrorless cameras are catching up. So you want to pay attention to the battery life when deciding the best video camera for you. The second thing you want to look at is the flip-out screen. Canon has some decent cameras with good flip-out screen. This Canon 90D has a flip-out screen. The reason why this is important is because when you're recording yourself, you want to be able to see your positioning and your framing in the shot. You want to make sure that you're standing in the right place and you're not recording maybe half your body's cropped off, like me cropped off here, or your head is like cropped down. And so you want to do the framing in a right way. So that's why you need a flip out screen. The second reason why you need a flip out screen is like when you're recording, if you want to record high, low, you can tilt the screen and you can see when you're recording low or you want to. So it offers you that flexibility to record videos in different angles. You want to be careful with the flip-out screen as well, because Sony cameras, for example, the flip-out screen comes the other way around and it sometimes is blocked by the microphone ports and the microphones, the external microphone. So you want to make sure that whatever camera you're getting, the flip-out screen is not being blocked by all the attachments you have around the camera. The third thing you want to consider when getting a video camera is your lens choices. So let's go into DSLR cameras and then mirrorless cameras. The DSLR cameras have a broader lens choice because they've been around for longer. Plus, they're cheaper lenses compared to the mirrorless range. So you have the opportunity to get a used lens, a secondhand lens off of eBay or any other websites, cheaper, cost effective. The mirrorless camera are fairly new, although they have lenses, but the variety of lenses they have is not as much compared to the DSLR cameras. So in my opinion, that's why I picked the 90D as the best video camera under £1,000, because it has a lot of lenses available for you to use on it. And number two thing you need to consider when it comes to lenses is you want to get a camera that has interchangeable lens. You don't want a camera that is point and shoot. If you're looking for a video camera for hobby, like it's just a hobby for you, you can get a point and shoot. Some point and shoot have good features and functionalities. But if you want a very good camera, you want to be able to take the camera, for example, to a sports event, big external opening, you need a wide angle lens. If you bring the camera indoor and you want to shoot a talking head video like I'm doing here, you need a smaller lens. I'm using a Sigma 30mm 1.4 lens here. So different situation when you're recording video requires different lenses. If you're going on holiday, say the safari, and you want to record videos of wild animals, you want a long telephoto lens because you're not going to be using a wide angle lens on a wild animal, you're going to get killed. So you need a long telephoto lens. So different lenses for different situations. So the best video cameras will give you that functionality, that opportunity to use different lenses. Another important thing you need to consider when getting a video camera is the 4K video. You want a camera that shoots 4K uncropped. I had to sell the previous camera I had after having it for less than 2 months, a Canon 250D, because although it has 4K in quote, the 4K was cropped and the dual pixel autofocus wasn't working on the 4K. So in my honest opinion, it was a useless camera from a 4K perspective. But the Canon 90D is a better option because Canon offers 4K uncropped for the first time. That is why this camera is the best camera for video, in my opinion. It's fairly recent and the 4K is excellent. I'm recording this video on 4K uncropped. So you also want to pay attention to the frame rate, because it's one thing for a camera to shoot 4K. It's another thing for it to shoot at the frame rates that you want. You want a camera that shoots 24 frames per second, 60 frames per second. And if you want slow motion, not 4K, 1080p, you can get a camera. This shoots 120 frames per second. So you want a camera that gives you that flexibility when it comes to frame rate. Number five, you want a camera that gives you the opportunity to listen to the audio. Not all cameras have headphone jacks. So when you're recording a video, you want to be able to plug in a headphone to monitor the quality of the sound. Is the sound very good or is it low? Is it high? I once recorded a 45 minutes meetup without volume because I was using a Canon 250D and it didn't have a headphone jack. So you want a camera that offers you headphone jack. Most cameras come with the microphone port, but you also want to make sure that these two ports are not being blocked by the flip screen. So some cameras will give you both or one of those features, but the flip screen will be blocked by those external microphone. You really, really want to make sure that you monitor that. The best way for you to really, really avoid the mistakes that I made buying two cameras and having to sell them to get this 90D is you want to rent a camera. If I had rented a camera from a friend or someone, I would have been able to understand that, okay, is this a camera I want to buy? Is it not the one? So save yourself that problem. Although I recommend the 90D. Number six, you want to look at the processor. Just like laptops and computers, more recent cameras have more updated processors. This Canon 90D has a Digic 8 processor, and it has dual face tracking and eye tracking. So a more recent Canon or Sony or Panasonic, whatever brand you choose to buy, make sure that the camera that you're buying is recent, less than 12 months. That doesn't necessarily mean the old cameras that are 2 years old, 3 years old are no good, but the more recent cameras have more updated technology, better functionalities, better processors. So the best video camera at the time of this recording is the Canon 90D. But when you're watching this video, make sure that you look at the camera that is more recent. If you're watching this video 2-3 years down the line, don't get a 90D at that time, but get something that is fairly recent. Stabilization. Some cameras will give you in-body stabilization where when you're recording a video handheld, it makes the footage very, very stable. My Canon 90D doesn't have image stabilization when it comes to in-body image stabilization. Let me be clear with that. But I record on a tripod. So if you're going to be recording or shooting videos on a tripod, you're good. But if you're going to be shooting videos handheld, you need to consider a camera with in-body stabilization. Another option is you can easily get a lens that has image stabilization within it, or it's sometimes called vibration compensation. So this, in my opinion, is the best video camera under £1,000. In the next video, I'm going to talk about the camera equipments and gears that you need. It's one thing to get a camera. You need to get other accessories to really give you the best in terms of recording good quality video. I'll leave links in the description below. And if you have any questions and any clarification that you need, please comment and post comments below and check out the links and subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Bye.